guys, welcome back to my channel. Tomorrow is the Chinese Lantern Festival. Have you heard of this holiday before? Today, I'm gonna share with you the origin story of the Lantern Festival, what do we do on this special holiday, and also a very simple holiday dessert recipe that you can enjoy making with your kids and family at home. Check it out. Right here. I'm a Taiwanese citizen, currently living in America. Cooking and traveling is my passion, so I'm here to share with you my favorite Asian recipes. On top of that, I also make videos talking about food knowledge and a history background of the dish on this channel, so if that interests you, please subscribe and keep watching. Before we get into the recipe part, I want to share with you what is the Lantern Festival. The Lantern Festival falls on the 15th of the first lunar month, which normally is around February or March in the solar calendar. The most important thing that we do during this holiday is written on its name, watching the lanterns. Why, you ask? Here we need to talk about the origin story of the Lantern Festival. Buddhism has always been the major religions in the Chinese culture. During the Han Dynasty, which is around 200 BC, the emperor of the time advocated Buddhism big time. He heard that in Buddhism, on the 15th day of the first lunar month, the monks will light up a lamp and worship the Buddhas in front of it. As a devout, he ordered that on the same day, all lights should be lit up in the palace and the temple around the capital. And no matter if you're a royalty or the civilian, worshiping Buddhas on the last day of Chinese New Year, which is the 15th of the first month of Lunar New Year, become the most important ritual for everybody. And over time, after bigger and bigger celebration each year in the capital, Lantern Festival has turned into a grand festival in the whole country and passed down till today. What are the traditions that we do on Lantern Festival? Today, during the Lantern Festival, there will be a lot of different kind of design lights lit up in the city. Children walking down the street with handheld lanterns. It's kind of like a warm-hearted but not scary Halloween. In Taiwan, a week before the Lantern Festival, the local government will start to give out the animal lantern to the kids in town for free. For example, this year is the year of the tiger, so if you live in Taiwan, you will see a lot of kids walking around the street with a handheld tiger lantern to celebrate the holiday. Another tradition that we do is guessing the lantern riddle. Back in the day, the lantern maker will write the riddle on its lantern and hang it on their doors. If someone can figure out the right answer, they will get a small gift. This tradition started around the Song Dynasty, which is around 1000 AD. And since there's only so many lanterns you can see in your town, this new riddle guessing activity started to be added into the festival since then. Last but not least, it's our food today. I figure almost every major holiday have their own signature food, and Lantern Festival is no exception. The Lantern Festival in Chinese, we actually call it Yuan Xiao Jie. And the character Yuan Xiao is actually the representative food of this holiday. Yuan Xiao, aka Tang Yuan, it is a dessert made with glutinous rice flour that's either solid or with filling. The solid ones are normally white and pink color, and the ones with the filling are generally either red bean flavor, sesame flavor, or peanut butter flavor. Tang Yuan sounds very similar to the word Tuan Yuan, and Tuan Yuan in Chinese means family reunion. Tang Yuan now is just a simple dessert that we eat any day of the year, but especially on the Lantern Festival, because it signifies the wishes of the good fortune for the upcoming year. And today, I'm going to teach you how to make the solid Tang Yuan and serve with a red bean soup. So without further ado, let's take a look at our ingredients today, shall we? Here's the ingredient that we'll need for today's Tang Yuan recipe, which is the sweet rice ball with red bean soup. Here I have some pre-soaked red beans, we'll talk about it more later. Besides the red bean, we'll also need some glutinous rice flour. This type of rice flour is different than the one we use in the prosperity cake. This one is glutinous, which means it's stickier, so it can create like a sticky ball. And besides this, we'll also need some rock sugar. If you don't have rock sugar, you can use the normal caster sugar as well. And last but not least is our berry to make our pink rice ball. You can either use a strawberry like me because I like this taste, or you can also use the raspberry. And besides these, the rest of the ingredient and the exact amount of ingredient will be listed in the description box down below.
There are two parts in this recipe. The first one is to make the sweet red bean soup, which takes around 90 minutes. And the other one is making the Chinese Tang Yuan, the sticky rice ball. And since the red bean soup takes longer, let's start with that. Here are the red beans that I pre-soaked last night. As you can see that the beans has turned into twice as big as its original size. Soaking the beans is very important because the dry red beans have a hard shell. But after cooking, it can taste softer than any other beans. Because the inner side of the red bean is starchy and really easy to absorb water. As long as we soak soft the outer shell, when we cook them later, it is easier for the water to get straight into the center of the bean. Using at least double the amount of the room temperature water to soak your red beans overnight will give you the best result. Never use hot water to soak your red beans because first, it will not make it faster, and second, you will lose all its nutrition. Now we want to wash our pre-soaked beans real quick and drop them into a pot. Fill it up with a lot of water and turn the heat up. Depending on the red bean that you purchase, a lot of the variety of red beans taste astringent when cooked, which is a pungent, tingly, and drying sensation that some people find unpleasant. So unlike soaking a mushroom, we will toss out the bean soaking water right away because it might not taste that good. When the water starts boiling, cover it up with the lid and turn the heat to medium-low. Set a timer for 5 minutes. Now the time is up. Turn off the heat and use a cloth to seal up the lid so the heat can remain in the pot for longer. And let it sit for 30 minutes. This step is using the remaining heat in the pot to slowly cook through the red beans without wasting more gas. Now, 30 minutes has passed, pour out the water and rinse the red beans real quick to wash away the astringent taste. If you don't mind the taste or you have a high quality red beans that does not taste like that, you can skip this part. And now we're officially ready to make our red bean soup. Drop the washed red bean back into the clean pot, add in 1 liter of water, and then bring it to boil. If you didn't switch up the water, make sure there's enough water in your pot, but not too much. 150 grams of red beans will pair perfectly with 1 liter of water. You can adjust the water amount later. If it's too dry, you can add a little bit more, but if you put too much, it might get too watery at the end. Now the water starts boiling, scoop out impurity bubbles, cover it up with the lid and let it cook in low heat for around 30 to 45 minutes, depending on your red beans. Keeping the heat low is very important because if you turn on the heat too high, the water will be rolling around in the pot and break our red beans. We want to cook through the red bean, but we don't want them to break. So now, while the soup is cooking, let's start to make our rice ball. Making Tang Yuan is very simple. All we need to do is find some glutinous rice flour and mix it with liquid. The perfect temperature of water to make Tang Yuan is around 65 to 70 Celsius, which in Fahrenheit is around 150 to 160 degrees. The traditional solid rice ball normally have two kind of color. One is white, the other one is pink. Back in the day, the pink ones are made with artificial coloring, but today we're going to make the pink one with a natural fruit color, strawberry juice. It is not only healthier, but will also give a rice ball some strawberry taste. The powder and water ratio is around 5 to 4. So with 100 grams of glutinous rice flour, we want to add in around 80 milliliters of water or a little bit more. I like to mix it in with the forks first and then use my hand to knead it into a dough. Rice powder is not like normal flour. It might look pretty dry, but after you knead it well together, it will turn into a very soft and malleable dough. When that's done, cover the dough up with a plate and let it rest for 15 minutes so the powder and liquid can combine well together. Same thing with the pink rice ball. The only difference is that the liquid that we're using is not water, but instead we're using strawberry juice. Get 80 grams of strawberry and add in 20 grams of water. use a blender to blend it into strawberry juice. And now since we have 100 grams of rice flour, we want to measure it again and make sure the liquid is 80 milliliters. Depending on the rice flour you got, 5-to-4 ratio is like the average ratio, but you might need a little bit more water if it's too dry. So that's why we make 100 milliliters of the strawberry juice, just in case. If you find it really hard to knead it into a smooth dough and it starts crumbling, that might mean that you need a little bit more water. But don't add too much all at once. Just knead your dough with a wet hand and the water will slowly be absorbed into the dough. Now, the same thing with the pink rice ball. Knead it into a dough and let it rest for 15 minutes. When the time's up, prepare a tray or plate with some rice flour in it to prevent sticking. Now open the lid and roll the dough into a long stick. Use a knife to cut it into little blocks and use your hand to roll them into smooth little balls and put it on the plate. My favorite size of the rice ball is around 3 grams a piece, but depending on your preference, you can adjust it into whatever size you prefer. During this process, if you find that your dough is falling apart again because it's too dry, you can wet your hand with some water or strawberry juice. And the dough will naturally absorb the liquid into it and create a perfect rice ball. Now the rice ball is ready, let's take a look at our red bean soup. We want the bean to be super soft that will almost melt in your mouth. If your bean is still too hard, just keep cooking 10 minutes at a time until it fits your standard of softness. And right before your red bean soup is ready, we can cook our rice balls. Heat up another pot of water and throw in your rice ball. Roll the rice ball around in the plate right before you drop into the water will help prevent sticking. As soon as the rice ball started to float on top of the water, that means it's 80% done. Let it boil for another 2 more minutes and you can see that the rice ball has expanded into 1.5 of its original size. That means it's ready. Turn off the heat and scoop them into a bowl. Now while the rice balls are still hot, add in 1 tablespoon of sugar and mix in well. The sugar will melt right away to first prevent it from sticking, second, adding sweetness into our rice ball, and third, give the rice ball a more springy and bouncy texture. Now my red bean soup is ready. You can either leave it as is, or if you prefer a thicker broth like me, you can scoop out a few scoops of the red bean soup and blend it into a red bean juice to be added back into the pot. Doing this can thicken up the soup a little bit and also give the broth more red bean taste. Now the red beans are cooked to perfection, it is time to add sugar. You can use whatever sugar you prefer. Today I'm using the mixture of the rock sugar and caster sugar, but if you don't have rock sugar, it is totally fine as well. The most important thing is to add in your sugar after you have cooked through your red beans. If you add the sugar too early, the pressure of the sugar water will be too high to let the water get into the beans. As a result, your red bean will not turn soft, like ever. After the sugar, we'll add in the cooked rice ball and a little bit of salt. Adding salt is to enhance the sweetness from the sugar, so we don't need to add so much sugar for real. Let it simmer for 3 more minutes, constantly stirring it to prevent the bottom from burning. And when the time's up, give it a little taste to see if the sweetness is enough for you. And done! Sweet rice ball with red bean soup is ready. Wow, the whole kitchen smells so good right now. The rice balls are springy and soft. It's almost like a boba tea. The usage of the rock sugar gives the soup a subtle sweetness, but not overpowering. The beans are cooked to perfection, soft but not broken. The starchy, sandy texture of the bean is almost like a liquid paste that will melt in your mouth. While we're enjoying this unique dessert of the Lantern Festival, let's learn some Chinese, shall we? The word of the day today is 元宵节, the Lantern Festival. The first two characters, 元宵, is the rice ball that we made today. You can also call it Tang Yuan. And the last character, 节, means holiday or festival. So 元宵节 is the rice ball holiday, aka the Lantern Festival. Thank you for cooking with me today. Let me know if you like this recipe by giving this video a thumbs up. It's only gonna take you a second, but it means a lot to me.
I make video on YouTube every Thursday, so remember to hit that bell and you'll never miss out. Last but not least, don't forget to subscribe on my channel if you haven't already, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye!